Hello, and welcome to Zoom webinar training. To begin, let's define what Zoom webinar is. Zoom webinar is a tool for virtual one-way communication with an audience of 100, 500, or up to 1,000 people or more via live stream, where only the host and panelists can be heard and seen, as opposed to Zoom meetings, which is intended for interactive, collaborative communication. Let's define possible roles in a Zoom webinar. The first role is the host. This is the person who schedules and manages the webinar, invites and manages panelists and attendees, and starts and stops the webinar. This person can also mute panelists, stop panelists' video, etc. A co-host, who can be set during the webinar, has most of the same controls as the host but cannot start the webinar. An alternative host can be set when scheduling the webinar. A panelist is a full participant who can view and send video, share their screen, make annotations on the screen, etc. A panelist must be assigned by the host. Finally, attendees. These are view-only participants who may only speak if granted permission by host or panelist. They cannot share their screen or their audio otherwise. They can, however, submit questions via Q&A and use the chat if it is turned on.
Let's schedule a webinar. Before you can schedule, please contact the Information Systems Multimedia team to request a webinar license. You may do this by either calling the service desk at 336-758-4357 or visiting help.wfu.edu. Here, you can search for Schedule a Large Video Conference. This will take you to the form to complete to request the license. After consulting with the multimedia team and receiving your license, you're ready to schedule. To schedule your webinar, visit zoom.wfu.edu and sign in. In the left panel, choose Webinars, then click on Schedule a Webinar. Enter your title. A description is optional. This will be a great place to include more details about your event if desired. Complete the necessary logistics. Please keep in mind that any recurring webinars will each require a license be issued to you for those dates. You have the option to add a registration requirement for your attendees. A webinar passcode is required. You may create your own passcode if desired. Video for host and panelists refers to whether or not the camera is on automatically when each joins the webinar. It's a great idea to allow attendees the option to connect to audio by either telephone or computer. Webinar options include Q&A. Be sure to check Q&A if you intend to allow this feature during the webinar. This must be selected prior to the event. Enable practice session. Your webinar will start in a practice mode for you, the host, and any panelists. No attendees are here. Enable HD video for screen shared video. This is not required, but if checked, please be aware of the warning about the strain on bandwidth. Only authenticated users can join. It is best practice to enable this. This requires that all attendees sign into their Zoom accounts. Automatically record webinar. If selected, the recording starts after you leave the practice session and go live or broadcast. Alternative hosts may be added by entering email addresses. Zoom will send an email invitation letting the recipient know they have been given host capabilities that include starting and ending the webinar. Interpretation is a new feature that allows you to enter the email addresses of any interpreters that you will have and the language to which they will interpret. Attendees can then select the language that they desire from within the webinar. They will hear the interpreter, and at a lowered volume, they'll hear the host. Click the Schedule button and your webinar is all set. After scheduling, you will have access to additional tools and settings. Invitations. Here you may invite panelists who may or may not be affiliated with Wake Forest University. email settings, branding, polls and surveys, where you're able to add your polls ahead of time, Q&A, and features concerning going live on social media. You're all set. Please continue on to part two of our Zoom webinar tutorial for great tips on the tools and features within a webinar.
When it's time to start your webinar, go to zoom.wfu.edu and click Sign In. On the left column, click Webinars. Locate your webinar, then click the Start button. Click to join the audio however you prefer. If you have enabled the practice session when scheduling your webinar, it's a good idea to go into the webinar 10 to 20 minutes before it begins to turn on all of the settings that you wish to have enabled. For example, you can mute or unmute yourself. You can start or stop your video. You can set a background if you would like by going into your upward arrow next to the start or stop video and choosing virtual background. You can also determine what you'd like your participants to be able to do. If I click on this participants button, on the right column here, I'll see my panelists and my attendees. Now, before my panelist arrives, I'm going to make sure she can do everything she needs to do by clicking this ellipsis in the bottom right corner of the participants panel. At the top here, I see all of the options that I can enable for a panelist. I can ask any or all of my panelists to unmute. I can mute them on entry. I can allow panelists to unmute themselves. Anything that's checked here is turned on and they can do this. I can allow my panelists to rename themselves. I can play a sound when someone leaves or joins. I could lock the webinar so that no further attendees may join. And of course, I have the option to allow panelists to start video. If I wish for my panelists to be able to share their video, I should leave this checked. Below that, I see options that I can give to my attendees. So I see the option to allow them to raise their hand and view the participant count. Below that, I see options for how the video layout will appear for attendees. The two options that we recommend you considering are Active Speaker View and Gallery View. Active Speaker View, if you have multiple panelists, will follow the person who is speaking. Gallery View, on the other hand, shows all panelists at the same time, regardless of who is speaking, and attendees will see all of them. This is entirely up to you as the host how you would like the layout to appear for attendees. When your panelists arrive, please note the More menu next to their names in the Participants panel, and all of the options and features listed here. All of these buttons, by the way, are toggle on, toggle off, so I'm going to click to turn off Participants. The next option that we see is Q&A. Here we have several options for how our question and answers will work. I recommend coming first to this gear icon where you have a couple of options. You can allow anonymous questions if you would like. You can check or uncheck that as you wish. Below that, you have the option to determine what your attendees will be able to view, whether that's answered questions only or all questions, as well as the ability for attendees to upvote or to comment on questions. These options are completely up to you. The next item we see are polls. You are welcome to set up a poll in advance, or you can add a question on the fly very simply by clicking Add a Question. This will actually take you out to the zoom.wfu.edu website where you'll create your question or questions. Once you come back in here to the webinar, you can launch the poll, and this window will appear where all attendees may answer the poll. The next option that we see is chat. Now, you might find chat to be redundant if you have Q&A turned on, so we recommend one or the other, Q&A or chat. If you wish to turn off chat, simply click the button Chat, and then off to the side here, at the bottom of the chat panel, click the ellipsis. Here is where you see the option for who attendees can chat with. You can change this to no one, all panelists, or all panelists and attendees. This is completely up to you. The next button that we see is Share Screen. Now, if you are familiar with sharing a screen in Zoom meetings, you'll be pleased to know that it looks exactly the same here in Zoom Webinar. I see all of the different windows and applications that I have open on my computer that I could choose to share. Click whatever you'd like to share, then click the Share button. When finished, click Stop Share. You'll also notice here on the toolbar, you've got the Record button. Again, just like in Zoom meetings, you have the option to record on this computer or record to the cloud. And finally, we see the More ellipsis. These options are for streaming. If you are anticipating more attendees than perhaps the licensing allows for, you can stream out to any of these live services. Once you are ready to open your webinar and allow all of your attendees in, you can simply click Start Webinar, and everyone who is attending will be able to come in. Keep in mind, you can't re-close the webinar. Once you start it, the doors are open, everyone is coming in. I'll go ahead and click Start Webinar. Once you click the Start Webinar button, you'll see your attendees arriving in the Participants panel. Note the option to allow an attendee to talk, and the More button, which allows you to chat to an attendee, promote an attendee to panelist, rename or remove an attendee. Throughout your webinar, note the Q&A notifications. Any questions that are asked will come in through this question and answer dialog box. You can choose to answer questions live, verbally, or you may type an answer, whether that's private or sent to everyone. Once you click Send, that question and answer go into the Answered tab at the top. You'll see remaining questions in Open, as well as any questions you choose to dismiss in the Dismissed section. At the end of your webinar, when everything is complete, click the End button. And then confirm by clicking End Meeting for All. If you have any questions about scheduling or hosting your Zoom webinar, please contact the Information Systems Service Desk at 336-758-4357, via email at help@wfu.edu, or via live chat at help.wfu.edu.